Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the training. First of all, thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules. This is Albert, in charge of server and storage solution for Advantech Sky Systems. It looks like everyone's here, so let's get started of today's training. Okay, first of all, I thought you have sold a lot of devices, edge devices or industrial personal computers to customers, right? So do you know what kind of software be installed on those devices you sold to customer, such as Windows 10, Microsoft SQL Server, etc.? And when devices breaks down, what is the follow action for customer to deal with the issue? For instance, customers create a or apply a RMA request or replace failure components with spare parts by themselves. In general, RMA service requires several days, the worst situation, even more than a month if there's a shortage of specific components. If customers replace failure parts by themselves should be faster. However, application on customer side must be stopped for a while because they have to check and then fix the device, right? So it is necessary to take some time from hours to several days to make service online again. General or unimportant service, perhaps it is okay to stop the service for a period of time. But for critical applications such as MES or SCADA, it would cause enormous losses due to unplanned downtime. So the reason we built fault tolerance system is to prevent critical service from interruption. So the first value we provide to customer is availability without downtime. What it means, fault tolerance system consists of two devices, could be two IPC or two servers. When one part breaks down, another one will automatically take over all services in 1 second without manual intervention and without any downtime. The second value of fault tolerance system is to support multi-OS running. So what is multi-OS running? As we know, one IPC or one server can only be installed of one operating system, no matter Windows or Linux, just one operating system, right? Thanks for virtualization technology. We could use more operating system, provide more application, which are isolated running on fault tolerant system. For example, one Windows 10, one Windows Server 2016, and one Linux Ubuntu are working at the same time. And these three applications are protected by fault tolerant system as well. I thought you might not get clear understanding of what I'm saying, so I prepared two short videos to share with you. The left side is an UNO, is an IPC running with HMI application. HMI is human machine interface application. On the right side is fault tolerance system. I will unplug power cables of both scenarios. Let's see what happened between single UNO and fault tolerance system. Okay, let us watch again. So it is very clear that conventional scenarios means single machine without any protection. We get used to this architecture for so many years, and the outcome meets our expectation. HMI service, HMI application definitely shuts down after losing power. When it comes to the right side, fault tolerance system, only 1 second delay. All services are switched to another server without interruption. So this is what we call fault tolerant protection. Perhaps you are wondering if fault tolerant is really important. Let me take a real case to explain the importance of it. This is a real case. Device broken at 2 p.m. and this customer had a premium support agreement with system integrator. Premium agreement means on-site support service that is provided 24 hours a day and 7 days a week. Engineers have to arrive at customer site in 2 hours and repair or replace broken device in 4 hours. In this case, the system integrator choose to replace a new one and service online again at 6 p.m. However, the last time customer back up their data was lunch break yesterday, and the data was used to system recovery. So finally, customer spent 4 hours for replacement, but recover contents, recover data to 30 hours before. Please imagine that if you have a time machine return to yesterday early morning, sounds amazing, but for production line, database is not funny. But what if customer choose another solution instead of expensive premium agreement? What happened? Device still break at 2 p.m. There would be only 1 second delay without any downtime. Each product line works well. That's Advantech fault tolerance system. As I mentioned, fault tolerance system consists of two devices. When one part breaks down, another one will automatically take over all services in 1 second. For critical service, fault tolerance system is very useful. The second value we provide to customer is to support multi-OS running. Single Uno, single IPC or single server, of course, runs one operating system. Please pay attention on the right side. There are four applications running on four operating systems, respectively, car recognition, SCADA, database, and HMI. The key point is that our fault tolerance system not only keeps application continuous working, but protects several operating systems and several applications at the same time. Fault tolerance system leverage on virtualization technology to achieve the goal, and customer would feel cost effective because they can install multiple operating systems or applications on only two devices. And now we are talking about architecture stack diagram of fault tolerance system. Regarding how fault tolerance system works, and it might be a little boring because it is a technical part. Therefore, I explain in simple way to make you get better understanding of it. First of all, two IPCs or two servers synchronize data to each other, which means both of them have the same data, the same contents, so that when one device breaks down, another one takes over in 1 second because they are twins. They are mirroring to each other and they are the same. The way customers set up applications and operating system is similar to single device. Fault tolerance system is compatible with Windows and Linux. So customer have no need to modify the configuration, and only one operating system or one application license requires. Is there any questions of this section? Anyway, I thought we will encounter some questions from you or from customer, but we can discuss after the presentation. Okay, after introduction of value we provide to customer, let us talk about specification of FT system, fault tolerance system. Two benefits, exclusive version and flexible configuration. The name of fault tolerance software is short as Everon, which is made by a United States company. Now, the company name is Stratus, and there are resellers and distributors selling Everon in the market. But Advantech, we signed an agreement with Stratus to have Advantech logo and exclusive version. A standard Everon license support 28 virtual machines. However, from our experience, manufacturing customers only need less virtual machine than IT application. Consequently, we have a special license that supports one processor and one virtual machine. It's suitable for integration of IPC. So the version cannot support multiple operating system running, but still has fault tolerant protection, and the cost is much lower than standard license in the market. However, if customer requires more computing resources and more virtual machines, we could follow customer's requirement to install one or two processors and from one to three virtual machines, such as the slide shows. Basically, this configuration is just for reference. We could replace server board, chassis, number of drives, and memories to meet customer expectations. So if you need someone go with detailed configuration with you, please let us know. We will assist you as well as discuss with customers to achieve the goals. So now we are making a short conclusion of FT system. When one device breaks down, another one automatically takes over all services in 1 second. The second value is multiple OS running on two devices. Our OEM license supports up to three virtual machines. So if customers require more, then they have to buy standard virtual license from Stratus channel. And the third is basically we have two kind of features, protection features. We call it fault tolerance. When one device breaks down, another one takes over in 1 second without any interruption. The other one is high availability. It takes 30 seconds to 1 minute to recover because the operating system will automatically reboot. High availability, HA version is lower cost than fault tolerance FT, and it is suitable for customers who have limited budget, or customers can stand for a little bit downtime. Both of fault tolerance and high availability, we have one CPU, one virtual machine version that is much lower cost, but powerful to help you to make sure customers' application continues running. Okay, and the next section contains many user cases and explanation of key to success. Regarding target customers, the major characteristic is that customer has very important service which cannot be interrupted. Otherwise, customer will pay a heavy price. such as reputation damage, money loss, database crashed, etc. Let me share a survey of what results in unplanned downtime with your customers. According to research institution, industrial automation works 168 hours a week, just 24 multiplied by 7 equals 168. For a production line, if one of them suddenly stops, customers undercharge $30,000 per hour. If customers encounter device failure each time per quarter and spend 4 hours fixing it. Why is 4 hours? Remember premium support agreement I mentioned before. Engineers have to arrive at customer site in 2 hours and repair devices in 4 hours. In this scenario, the annual downtime cost would be $480,000. Consequently, the institution gave a conclusion that unplanned downtime is the killer of manufacturing and the root cause of inefficiency. What if customers choose Advantech fault tolerance system instead of the old architecture under the same conditions? Annual downtime cost is still $480,000. Just one-time purchase for fault tolerance system. The fault tolerance system will eliminate additional cost by service stopping and ensure all applications continuous running even if one device fails. When it comes to money, I believe customers would pay more attention to their environment and evaluate if they have room for improvement. Now, I thought you may know what is the major characteristic of target customers. Once critical application be stopped, tragedy happens. That is the characteristic of target customers. Now we are talking about how to sell fault tolerance system among different categories of customers. DFSI means domain focused system integrator. No limitation in specific field could be manufacturing, transportation, medical, etc. Enterprise, Advantech can only reach to OT side for big company because IT side usually has the myth of branding. But we do have some success stories to share with you. Vertical market means tender. The major task is to spec in fault tolerance system as a necessary component of tender document. Vertical market is not easy to spec in. You have to cope with everything at the initial stage of tender. I'm taking real cases to explain how to sell fault tolerance system regarding their three types of customers in the following pages. Domain-focused system integrator. Take Leeds Automation as an instance. Leeds Automation mainly provides warehouse and parking management solution. Has already cooperated with Advantech for more than decades. The key point is that we sold a lot of IPC, sensors, or industrial switches to them for front-end application. But there must be a centralized server or powerful IPC giving commands to control these edge devices. And this centralized controller should be protected in order to prevent from unplanned downtime. However, Leeds Automation founded in 1988, which means this history is more than 30 years. It is a sure thing that Leeds Automation has some technical skills to protect the centralized controller in the past 30 years. Consequently, our first job to understand what technology DFSI are currently using and try to convince them use fault tolerance system instead of the old one. Let me introduce what kind of solution should be replaced by fault tolerance system. In this page, basically, it's very common for system integrators to use backup software such as Acronis, Symantec to regularly backup their data. Once device breaks down, just replace a new device and restore data from backup software they backup before. Sounds easy, but in fact, the operation is a little complex and recovery job takes from minutes to hours. So that we know backup software is not a good choice for critical service because recovery job may take a period of time. Another technology is clustering, such as Windows Server, VMware, etc. Actually, clustering means similar quality of our fault tolerance system. However, setting up clustering is difficult. Sometimes you have to get sort of certification or outsourcing deployment to other partners. Outsourcing deployment is not very well from sales perspective because temporary partnership for outsourcing might compete with you in the future. So this automation is good at edge computing, but the outsourcing they leverage on other partners to deploy clustering. They choose fault tolerance system instead of clustering to eliminate the sales concerns and additional cost. So consequently, as I mentioned, for domain-focused system integrator, our job is to understand what technology they are using and convince them substitute fault tolerance system for old solution. The next is how to sell fault tolerance system to enterprise. In my opinion, we should pay more attention on their branch office or tier two services. The reason comes that too many vendors surrounded their headquarters or primary services. Apart from competition, enterprise usually have the myth of branding, perhaps HP or Dell, etc. However, there might be some business opportunities at their branch site. Branches usually have lower budget and lower frequency of hardware upgrade than headquarters. So it makes sense there are fewer competitors surrounding branches. The major concern of branches is budget and stability. And our Advantech fault tolerance system have advantage at this point. Let me explain. In the past, branches follow headquarters to buy the same equipment when they need system protection. But branches are not data centers, just a few computers working together. But branches still bought the same things as headquarters because they didn't find a better way to deal with it. VMware and Microsoft are mainstream products to provide fault tolerant protection. But things like the picture, standard hardware requirement of VMware requires 3 servers, 2 switches, and 2 storage. And Microsoft clustering requires fewer, but at least 4 devices. To be honest, VMware and Microsoft are very successful software companies, but their purpose is to build data center and provide cloud relevant functions. So computing, networking, and storage are separately existed. Most branches only need to ensure 1 or 2 applications continuous running. Too many devices cost waste of money and hard to manage. This is a comparison table among Advantech fault tolerance system, VMware, and Microsoft clustering. It apparently shows that fault tolerance system can easily meet branch's budget because our solution consists of two devices only. And fault tolerance system is also easy to learn by its intuitive graphic interface. It is important for branches as a result of IT resource shortage in remote sites. Considering all these factors, IBM Indonesia, Formosa Plastic, and in the countryside, and Delta Power Manufacturing, their tier two business, Green Power, buy in our Advantech fault tolerance system. Therefore, I would say branches of enterprise are target customers of fault tolerance system. The last I would like to share is vertical market, which usually happens in tenders. We should cope with everything at the initial stage, because the most important thing is to spec in fault tolerance system as a necessary component of tender. Take ETC, electronic toll collection, as an instance. This is a transportation tender. For ETC, if system crashed, the section can no longer calculate tolls and traffic flow until replacement of system. It may take several hours to fix the issue, so ETC should be protected by a fault tolerance system. Air quality analysis comes from government regulation. In order to decrease air pollution, chemical industries have to upload air analytic data to administration every minute. As long as stop uploading data more than 1 hour, the company will receive a huge fine, approximately $50,000. In this situation, fault tolerance system obviously becomes a necessary component of tender. Vertical market is not easy, but once we successfully spec in fault tolerance system, the outcome would be amazing. Take ETC project in China, produce over $3 million revenue, and the air quality analysis tender might achieve $1 million this year. One thing needs to be noticed is that you have sold a lot of edge devices to those vertical markets, perhaps industrial switches, sensors, or IPCs. So fault tolerance system is not really a new business for you, just a new way to extend revenue and make product lineup become a complete one-stop solution. I also have two case studies of manufacturing to share with you. The first is Worley. The primary service of the company Worley is to provide MES solution and integration of factory environment, as the picture of the slide. Worley purchased fault tolerance system because they were searching add-on value to win the project from competitors. Another reason is that they don't need to spend additional resources modifying any settings, just install their software on fault tolerance system, and they suddenly have redundant ability to protect their MES environment. In the future, Worley could also take fault tolerance function as an optional item of their data sheet for their customers to order. Another case belongs to manufacturing as well. BroTech mainly provides high-speed system, high-frequency and high-consumption system for PCB board. After BroTech encountered several times of unexpected power loss, they decided to deploy two servers in different locations in order to prevent from power off on single site. Our fault tolerance system achieved their goal of cross multi-site protection and ensure all applications continually running, even if one part lost power. So the conclusion of Advantech's fault tolerance system regarding the value is avoid system downtime and multi always running. Regarding the spec, Advantech have exclusive version different from standard version in the market. And Advantech also have flexible configuration. We can build any kind of fault tolerance system to meet your customers' needs. Perhaps two servers or two fanless IPC. And the target customers so far we have our domain focus SI, enterprise branches, and vertical applications.